Hello, everyone. Welcome to Wednesday. Passover begins at sundown, April 5th, 2023. And in order to honor my Jewish friends, I just looked up Passover Tangles, and there really wasn't anything specific, but this image popped up, and I really like it. It speaks to me, but instead of doing a regular five-pointed star, I'm going to use the Jewish Star of David as my center piece, and then I'm going to work myself outwards in this, just doing an aura sort of a thing, and that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to turn on my light, zoom you guys out just a little bit because you're too close. I'm going to draw my star. I'm going to draw a border. You know, I like a good border. And I'm going to put my star right about here. So basically, it's two triangles stacked on one another. Doing a very good job of making them even, though. That's better. All right, we've corrected our pencil lines. It's close. It's not perfect. Am I ever perfect? No. And that's okay, because I am the way God made me. Just going to do that. That's close enough. And what size am I going to draw with? I'm going to draw with this size. I'm going to make a nice big border. Is my star in the middle? No, it's not. I did that on purpose. And we're just going to do our best here. To read a little bit about the Star of David. It is generally recognized as a symbol of both the Jewish identity and Judaism. Its shape is that of a hexagram, compound of two equilateral triangles. Mine are not as equilateral as they probably could be. A derivation of the Seal of Solomon, which was used for decorative and mystical purposes. Its adoption as a distinctive symbol for the Jewish people religion dates back to the 17th century. Interesting things. So then here I'm going to come outward from each of these central bits with a lovely little ribbon. Like that. Wherever it ends up living. Just like so. There we go. Now we're just going to aura. And that's all we have to do. Makes it simple, doesn't it? It's a simple drawing. Don't remember what the theory of the pattern is for this when you aura this way. I'm sure this pattern has a name. I just don't remember what it is. Hurry? That Hurry that had the pattern that was like this? I'm going to aura in here as well. Is my triangle perfect? No. I mean, my triangles aren't perfect because I know that because all of those aren't the same size. That better. Okay. And you know what? Rather than going around and around, I could do this. And I could go like this and then like this. And then like this. Do that twice in each section. What is Passover?
Egyptian slavery, lasting 7 or 8 days from the 15th day of Nisan.
Thank you. So it's sort of a the Jewish version of 4th of July. Yes? In a manner of speaking. So it's a celebration of independence. And I like this symbol, and this pattern that's coming out here. Best friend has a brother who converted to Judaism when he married his wife many, many years ago. And although I was never really close to that brother, because my friend is 10 years younger than her next oldest sibling, and like 15 or more years younger than oldest brother the one I'm speaking of. By the time I met her, her brother was long moved out of the house. So I know him. I would recognize him by sight, but I don't know him. Does that make sense? So I've never really spoken to him about his choice of changing faiths in order to marry the woman he loved. I think that's a noble thing to do. Is it drastic? Yeah, I think it is kind of drastic. But to have that kind of commitment to investigate and to explore another faith when you fall in love with somebody who is of a different faith than you is a pretty powerful thing. My friend has not always understood her brother's choice, but of course she loves her brother and she loves her sister-in-law and her nephews, and so when they come for visits and so forth, she does her best to accommodate their dietary restrictions and that kind of thing. I have forgotten where I'm at. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4. How did that happen? I was talking and not paying attention to where I was at. Question is, do I want to fill this, or do I want to leave it like that? Or do I want to just go ahead and let it fill? I'm feeling like I want to leave it. Just verify that I have the right number of bits and pieces. What's going on here with my headphone? I don't know. It feels weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. That's where I goofed up. That has one too many. 4, 5, 6. Okay, so that one's got one too many. So I got to go around again. Let me put a little mark there. I got to go around again on these other ones. Now they should be the same number outward from the center. And think I'm going to color in the back here in a dark blue. Ultramarine, Prussian blue, a cobalt blue, there's a Delft blue. Ultramarine violet. Indigo. Well, we'll go with Prussian blue. It might look purple. No, that's blue. Seemed to be a little darker in the middle. Worked my way outward a little lighter, which is okay. Someone's probably going to ask me about my pencils. I'm using these Castle Arts colored pencils. For a budget pencil, they're a good pencil. I like them. Would I do like super commission work with them? I don't know, maybe not. Just coloring in a simple daily drawing. Yep, that's all I'm doing. I don't need super high quality supplies. I'm just making a humble drawing, you know? And of course, you know, as soon as I bring out the colored pencils, then the length of the video extends. So you always know when you look at a thumbnail, if I have colored it in, it's going to be a longer video. Just from the thumbnail, you will be able to tell that. I'm going to remind you guys that if you haven't subscribed yet, to do so, because once I hit that 30,000 subscriber mark, I'm going to give away a whole bunch of my artwork that I've done recently. If you want a chance to win this piece of art or any others in the last month or so, make sure we get to that 30,000 subscribers. That would be awesome. Do I ever think I will ever get to that 100,000 subscribers and get a YouTube play button? I don't think so, but you never know. I'm almost a third of the way there, and you know, I don't plan on going anywhere for many, many years, so give me another 10, 15 years and I might get there. Maybe. Unless, of course, YouTube just decides that art videos are something that they don't want to promote anymore, and then they just disappear off the platform, which might also happen because, well, we're not going to disappear off the platform. They're not going to make it so that we can't upload a video. It's just they make it so hard for people to find us. I've noticed that many of my favorite art content creators have moved on to making content that is more comical or exciting or edit heavy, and the concentration on pure art has just kind of disappeared, which makes me very sad because there's a couple of creators I've stopped watching because their content, they're following the algorithm. They're doing what people want to watch, which is fine, but it's not what I want to watch, and so I've stopped watching. Especially the ones who've gone to a pure vlog format. I don't really like watching people's vlogs. The only vlogs I watch really are the people who are narrowboat cruisers, because I like watching the scenery go by and learning about their lifestyle. But, you know, art vlogging, not necessarily exciting to me. I don't know. Oh, I like that. Okay, let's sharpen our pencil and do the middle of the star. Okay. I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that look. I want to get a little bit of shading in here. Let's do the B pencil. Just to do a little bit. I don't have to do a lot. Shall I do a question while I'm doing this? Let's do that. Give me something to talk about. If you knew that the world would end in 24 hours, what three things would you do in the time you had left? I would pack myself and my husband up in the car, gather the rest of our extended family and meet them somewhere, anywhere. Meet them halfway, have them all drive to our house, have us drive to their house. Probably meet them halfway because that would be saving us an extra few hours and just spend time loving on each other. That's what I would do. My very first thought was I would need to be with my boy and my husband. blending stump. I need a new package of blending stumps, I think. Is this the pattern called Log Cabin? It might be. Or Aura Knot? I'm going to look it up. I will figure it out and I'll put it in the title of the of this video if I can find it. The pattern that this is based on. Arukas? Might be Arukas. Let me look that up. Let me look that tangle pattern up and see if that's correct. Tangle pattern Arukas.
Check out these pictures.
Yes. Yes. Arukas. Came to me in a flash. Which way do I want it to live? Let's have it live that way. Arukas with a star base. That's what that is. Alrighty, you guys have a great day. Have a blessed one. If you are celebrating Passover, I pray that it's that your traditions bring you peace and comfort, and that all goes well with whatever the tradition is. I don't know it. I just don't, and I'm sorry that I'm unfamiliar with all of the traditions. I know there's a lot of food, a lot of tradition, and I hope that you have a great time with your Passover meal and celebration. And as you celebrate the great gift that God has given you for my brain has just gone blank. I apologize for my just having no words. Freedom. That's I pray for all of us to have the freedom that we long for, to be able to worship without boundaries, in a place where we can all be free to express our own individual relationship with our God, or not, if that's what you are doing. Oh my goodness, look at all those little spiders. I have little spiders in my room. That's no good. Okay, well, we'll have to take care of that. Dust those little guys out. You guys can live outside. All right, like I said, you guys go out and do something nice for someone today. Have a blessed day, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.